everybody, and welcome back to another Wheel of Time video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the TV show adaptation and essentially responding to some ideas of what should be cut from the show. Mainly, I'll be responding to Daniel Green's latest video addressing what he believes will be cut from the show. So certainly before watching this video, go check out Daniel's video so you'll have a context for what I'm talking about. It's a really great video with some awesome points. Obviously, I'm a big fan of Daniel Green. Definitely check out his channel if you haven't done so already, but go watch that video right now and come back and watch this after if you haven't done that. The link is in the description below. Also, before diving too deeply into the video, I want to give a shout out to my main sponsor here on the channel, Audible.com. Audible is the largest provider of audiobooks in the world, and I use Audible service daily. I get asked a lot on my Discord server whether audiobooks are worth giving a shot, and my answer to that is, yeah. It gives you a totally different experience, and it allows you to read while traveling and cleaning, and I absolutely love it. Kate Redding and Michael Kramer, the narrators for the Wheel of Time audiobooks, are absolutely amazing. If you want to check out the audiobooks but aren't sure if you'll like them, there's a great way you can try them out without any risk and without paying any money. All you have to do is head to www.audibletrial.com/nablus and sign up for a free trial there. You greatly support the channel by doing so, and you'll get a free audiobook that you can keep, regardless of whether or not you decide to keep the service. It's a great deal, and I highly encourage you to take advantage of the offer if you haven't done it already. This video will carry a spoiler rating of red, with spoilers all the way through A Memory of Light. Please don't spoil yourself. Wait and watch the video when you finish the entire series. You have been warned. So the main topic I'm going to address in this video is The Forsaken and whether or not they should be cut down when adapting the books into the TV show. If you watched Daniel's video, you'll notice that one of the things that he stated was the need to cut the number of Forsaken down to a smaller, more manageable number. What I want to do in this video is do a bit of a deep dive into that topic and really come to a decision on whether or not I agree with that take or not. But to do that, we first need to look at some adaptation concepts and really the process used for making television adaptations. So let's start with the reasons that things are cut from a show to begin with. It's almost always necessary to cut things in an adaptation. It's essentially a given that things are going to be cut or changed or sometimes even added to a story. This is an absolute certainty in the Wheel of Time TV show. So let's take a look at some of the reasons that it's necessary to do that before we take a look at whether or not The Forsaken should be cut. The first reason things are cut is for simplification of the plot for sake of time. Theoretically, a book series can go on indefinitely, but there are limited amounts of screen time that can be given in a television adaptation of said book. So very often, if not for any other reason than trying to fit a story into a smaller amount of time, the story must be simplified and cut down for length. Another reason things can be cut is simply that the story in general has certain elements that may not translate from the book to the show. Because a television show has less time to explain complicated plot elements, sometimes the story must be simplified so it'll be more easily digested by the audience and they won't get lost. Budgetary reasons can be another major reason for a cut. This could be as much as not wanting to hire actors for a role if it isn't a big role, or not feeling as though the actor or plot device is necessary to the story or worth spending money on. This could also mean CGI effects, all of that. Money is a factor. Lastly, a cut can be made for a thematic reason. This happens more in what's called pragmatic adaptation, but this is where a character or event from the novels doesn't fit the narrative for the adaptation, so they're removed or combined with another character. So these are reasons something would be cut, but let's focus back on the question of The Forsaken. Do they make sense to cut or whittle down for the show? Well, their appearances are spread out through the course of the books, some of them having very important arcs that span multiple books. A few of them have fairly minor roles and only show up in small doses. So what would be the main advantage for cutting them? I like to think the argument for cutting them would simply be that the story would have fewer characters to follow and keep track of as villains. None of the Forsaken have huge amounts of time invested into them, so I don't think cutting for the sake of time will be the reason. Also, if you cut one Forsaken for time, you would still have to put another one of them in their role if you want to keep the story the same. For instance, if you wanted to cut Balal, you'd still have to put a Forsaken in Tyr to confront Rand and spring the trap. That is, unless the story itself is going to be massively changed. I don't think this is the route they will go, because at that point, with such a large story, there are all kinds of collateral effects for removing one of the Forsaken. which will cause more problems and from a time perspective than it will solve. I don't believe any of the characters will be cut for budgetary or thematic reasons, as I don't think based on what we've seen that there will be a lack of a budget, and I don't believe they are changing the theme enough that any of the Forsaken wouldn't fit thematically in the story. So based on all this, it's fairly clear if they're going to cut a Forsaken, it will be for the purpose of simplifying the story. Basically, cutting one of them must make the story more simple for an audience to understand and not impact the major plot lines of the show. So based on those two criteria, what Forsaken will they cut? Well, let's take a look at them and what their roles were one by one and decide whether or not each one should be cut. Let's start with the major Forsaken. These are characters that have big roles throughout the series, lots of page time, and a very distinctive plot line. I would group Ishamael, Lanfear, Samael, Grendel, Asmodian, and Mogideon into these roles. All of them have major roles within the series, and removing any one of them would drastically change the story. None of these characters could be combined with each other to simplify, and cutting them from the story would significantly change the plot and arc of the story in general. I don't think any of them will be cut in any way. That's not to say that their stories won't be slightly modified, but I don't think any of those are going to get cut. So let's look at the next tier of Forsaken, and these are the moderately important characters. They have big roles in the books, they just don't have a ton of page time devoted to them. I would include Demondred, Semirog, and Ravine in this group. Cutting any of these characters would involve changing the story a decent amount, but it might simplify things. Demondred doesn't play a major role in the story until the last battle. If he were removed, they would need to place another of the surviving Forsaken into the role of battle commander for the Forces of Shadow. I'm not sure that any of them fit the bill unless they allow Samael to live past a Crown of Swords, but that seems unlikely to me. I don't believe Demondred gets cut. In fact, he has such a compelling backstory and off-page actions in the books, I think his character will actually be expanded upon. Semirog spends most of her time with the Seanchan. She isn't on the page often, but her role in manipulating the Seanchan and capturing Rand with the male Edom are major plot elements, and she's the one that takes his arm off, forces him to almost kill Rand, which contribute to his growing madness. She's the most sadistic and seemingly evil of the Forsaken, and she's a very compelling and horrifying character, really. I think removing her would be a mistake, and would cause the showrunners to have to put someone else with the Seanchan, which doesn't really simplify or solve any problems. I think she stays. Ravine spends his time capturing Andor and manipulating Morghaz, actions that have lasting consequences throughout the story, even though he's long dead. He also has a very climactic battle scene with Rand and Nynaeve. If he were cut, someone else would have to do these things. Samael possibly could, but does it really make sense for Samael to conquer multiple nations? And Rand really couldn't even kill him at the end of Fires of Heaven then. Ravine is a good villain with a very concise arc that only spans a few books. It really doesn't make a ton of sense to cut him from the story. So our last group of Forsaken are those with roles that I believe are candidates for pruning, just given the small roles that they had. This list includes Aghanor, Balthamel, Messana, and Balal. Aghanor first appears at the end of The Eye of the World, where he's killed in battle with Rand. He is later resurrected as Osangar, where he masquerades as Korlan Dasheva in the Black Tower, and stays close to Rand before trying to kill him in the Path of Daggers, and eventually being killed at the Cleansing. He's an interesting one to examine because he doesn't play a huge role in the Eye of the World, and his role could easily be replaced with just Ishamael being the only Forsaken at the Eye of the World. But then we wouldn't get to see the resurrection as a weapon of the Dark One. Also, the idea of a Forsaken hidden among Rand's closest advisors that we know about as an audience, but he doesn't, is a great tension builder for the show. Or if we didn't know about it, it would be a great twist to see him finally revealed as being a Forsaken. Cutting him removes these dramatic elements. He doesn't play a major enough role that cutting him would significantly save time, and having someone else play his role would be equally as complex. The only option is if he was cut to remove his role from the series entirely, having no one be masquerade as an Ashaman. Well, that is possible. I'm not sure if it really simplifies anything to the point where it's worth it to cut for the sacrifice of losing those plot elements. The same arguments can be made about Balthamel. He dies quickly to the Green Man in the Eye of the World, and he's resurrected as Halima later. As Halima, he causes headaches to Egwene, both figuratively and literally, in a great amount of tension as there is a Forsaken close to one of our favorite characters. I don't believe cutting that storyline would make the series better or save any real amount of time. In fact, it would take away some of the tension from these moments. I don't think that either Balthamo or Aganor should be cut. Mesaana spends her time in the series within the White Tower, and she is the cause of a great deal of strife there. She orchestrates the capture of Rand and the split of the White Tower, and while her role is important, it technically could be accomplished by just the Black Aja, or even Ishamael manipulating events if we want to remove her. She serves as the final boss fight for Egwene as she finally unifies the White Tower. Now this is the time where you have to take a step back and look at things. She could be removed without damaging the story much, but it wouldn't make much sense for there to not be a Forsaken in the White Tower. There are Forsaken in most of the major nations of the world. Either you'd have to remove that theme from the books that they've infiltrated major locations, or you'd have to make it so somehow the White Tower got left out of this, which doesn't make a ton of thematic sense. Mesaana doesn't have a major on-screen role. Removing her wouldn't save time. Would it simplify the story? Well, I'm not sure that it really does. Let's say, for instance, that you have Grendel play her role in the White Tower. How does that simplify anything? You'd have a character involved doing the same things, but Grendel's plots would be all over the place. Would Egwene fight Grendel at the end? Or would you remove that entirely then? For the simplification gains of removing Mesaana, I'm not sure that it really gains you anything significant enough to warrant the change. Lastly, we have Belal, the Forsaken with the least amount of page time in the entire series. He orchestrates the plot to capture Rand and gain Kalendor for himself, only to be balefired out of existence by Moraine in a surprise attack. I believe that he could easily be removed from the story, replaced by Ishamael in regards to the plan and even the final battle in the Stone of Tyr, as Rand battles Ishamael there anyway. There would be very little collateral damage to the plot, and it would, in fact, simplify the story. But here we go with the bigger question. If only one of the Forsaken could really be removed without much damage to the story, is removing one Forsaken really worth doing? It changes the mythology of the story, and it doesn't simplify that much, and doesn't really save much time from the plot. And let's say you wanted to cut all four of the last group of Forsaken I just mentioned. How much damage does that do to the story? Looking at the cost-benefit analysis, does it really save enough time or simplify the plot enough to cut all of them to make it worth changing the story that much? You could actually argue that the changes you would need to make to the plot to cut four Forsaken from the story would have the opposite effect. It would complicate things more rather than simplify. If I take all of that into account and then look at some of the low-hanging fruit in regards to things that can be simplified from the story elsewhere, in regards to minor Aes Sedai, focuses on small side plots that have little effect on the main story, I think that there are just better cuts to be made elsewhere that have less effect on the overall story. My final opinion on the matter, I don't believe that Forsaken should be cut at all, as there's better places to simplify the story elsewhere. But what do you all think? Please let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to grab your free audiobook by clicking the link in the description below. And please like the video and subscribe to the channel if you want to be updated when I release new Wheel of Time content. We should be getting some new information on the show here soon, so make sure to click the bell icon so you can see my content as it comes out quickly. I'll be responding to any TV news that we get as soon as we get it. Also, if you want to support what I'm doing here, please take a moment and check out my Patreon page. You can really support what I'm doing and get some cool rewards at the same time. Thank you guys all for watching. Until next time, peace out.
Tinker in the kitchen with a job of work to do. Mistress up above, slipping on a rope of blue. She prances down the staircase, a fancy oh so free. Crying, Tinker, oh dear Tinker, won't you mend a pot for me?